When Weed woke up one morning, the garden seemed full of dust.
Flubber-dubber-duff.
Yes, Bill, I did cough. There's not been much rain, so the garden's very dusty.
Flubber-dubber-flubber-dust.
We need to clean up the dust, Ben. We need a duster.
Flubber-dubber-duster?
A duster's a cloth for cleaning things.
Flubber-dubber-up.
There. I'll rub it off.
What are you two up to, Ben?
Flubber-dizzle. Rubber flust. What is here?
Oh, what a fuss. We thistles don't mind a bit of dust.
Rubber flust weed.
Well, of course weed needs to be dusted. She'd have to be very clean to be as lovely as a thistle.
Flubber-dubber-dee-da-thistle.
You say weed is lovely, Ben, but I've never seen her.
Bill said Weed would come and meet Thistle, but Weed had never left her own corner of the garden.
Rubber flubber sleeve. Flubber slubber lub. Flub.
Bill had an idea. Perhaps Weed could meet Thistle after all. Next door, Rose was teaching her buds to keep clean.
Shake off the dust. Like this.
Yes, Rose, we'll keep clean.
We must always be ready for visitors to look at us and say, "My, what a lovely rose."
Must we?
I would like to meet Thistle Bill, but I don't really want to be dug up and carried about.
Flubber-dubber, that's a cleaner weed.
Thank you, Ben. I feel much cleaner. I would like to see what the rest of the world looks like, you know.
Bill and Ben promised that Weed would see the rest of the world, but they didn't know how.
It's flubber-dubber-slop.
I'm out for a straw, Bill. I only left home yesterday, and already I've got as far as this sprout.
And flubber-dubber-word-a-weed.
I should think Weed would like to see the world. I do. That's why I take long walks. Now, Weed is stuck in the ground. Tricky. Got it! If Weed can't go to the world must go to Weed.
Flub?
We'll collect interesting things from around the world and show them to Weed.
Flubber, 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 flubber.
Oh, yes. A sprout is an interesting thing. I shall show Weed a sprout.
Bill and Ben raced around the garden, collecting interesting things to show Weed.
Well, a seed packet's an interesting thing, Bill. It'll show Weed what goes on in the greenhouse.
Ben thought a lump of mud would show Weed what a dirty part of the world looked like.
Flubber-deen.
Yes, they're all interesting things. There's just one tiny problem. This is very kind of you, but I have seen a brick before and a lump of mud. But I still don't know what the places they come from look like.
A flubber-dubber-nature.
Yes, Bill. I would know what they look like if I saw a picture.
So, our interesting things aren't enough for Weed, eh? Well, in that case, I'll eat this sprout.
Flubber-dubber-nitches.
I'll teach you to make pictures. I could have been a great artist, you know. If only I'd had the fingers for it. Now, you can paint pictures, or you...
Flubber-dubber-dubber-date.
We'll let Ben do the painting, Bill. come inside. You can draw pictures of the rest of the world with these pencils. You'll need paper.
Ooh, flubber paper.
You'll find some in that book. Yeah, throw away all the bits with the funny marks on. Now try the pencils.
Ow! Ooh, something hit me. Ow! Oh! What's going on? Ow! Help! Ah! Stop it! Oh! Oi, what's your boo? What are you doing? Learning to dance? Ow! Oh, I'm leaving. Well, that's very odd. Ah! Oi! Oof! Oi, hey! Cut that out! Flubber slubber draw! Hey! Oi! I'll tell you what, now you know how to draw, make a picture of Rose. She'd love that.
Ben had found his brush and paint. Now he needed some paper.
Oh!
Now Ben had more paper than he needed.
Flubber lub!
I can't wait to see your drawing, Bill.
Ah! Flubber nose!
Oh! But it's nothing like me! I'm not grey, I'm red! With green bits!
Hello, Ben. Are you painting a picture of the compost heap?
Flubble up.
Is this another picture of the compost heap?
Flubble up.
Oh, that's the shed. What's this one?
Flubble thistle.
That's thistle, is it? I see. Yes. What a pity you've only got one colour.
Oh, flubber night!
Oh, I see. It's a picture of thistle at night.
Later on, Bill and Ben showed their pictures to Slowcoach.
Dear me. My word. Oh, dear. These pictures look nothing like the rest of the world. Never mind. It was your first try.
Flubber-deed.
I know you promised to show Wade some pictures. Well, you're in luck. I have a fine collection of pictures. Look in that box. They're pictures of the rest of the world.
They're very good pictures. I am pleased to see the rest of the world, Ben, but just look at all that snow. Look at all that water. And all those people. Now I know what the world looks like, I'm very glad I live in our own quiet corner of the garden.
Bill and Ben agreed with Weed, but they were happy to live in their own corner of the garden. And they promised Weed they would always keep it free of dust.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
Early one morning, Bill, Ben and Little Weed were woken by a lot of angry voices.
Tell you the truth, smells don't usually bother me. Come across all sorts as I'm recycling and turning the earth I do. But this,
that's enough to curdle my nuts, really it is. If it gets into them, my whole winter hoard will be ruined.
Oh, it's
a I'm sorry. I don't know. Really, I can't do that. One at a time, please.
Flubberweed.
Flubble, I'll
never get anyone but them.
Please. That's enough. One at a time. Well, can't you smell it?
Weed and Bill and Ben sniffed the air.
Oh, my. What is that awful smell?
We thought it might have something to do with you two.
Flubber does?
Flubber way!
It certainly is a horrible smell. And I'm sure that Bill and Ben are just as anxious as you to get rid of it. Then why don't you go and see if you can find out what it is?
Bill and Ben agreed that this was a very good idea indeed. They thought it would be a bit like being detectives.
Flubber Derlock Holmes!
Flubber Dan Spade!
The flowerpot men decided to follow their noses. And wish they hadn't.
Well, whatever it is, let's hope you find it soon.
Bill thought they should start looking in the potting shed.
Flubber-dubber-dead.
Ben thought the kennel would be a good place to begin.
Flubber-dennel.
Then the same idea occurred to them both.
Slobber-dob. Slobber-dob.
Slobber-dubber-dubber. Poo.
Slobber-dubber-dubber-dub.
Bill and Ben decided that as Slowcoach wasn't at home, they'd go in and have a look around. They were detectives after all. Bill and Ben searched Slowcoach's house for the smell, but it didn't seem to be there.
Blob.
Not much further.
Here we are.
Yo, what do you think you're doing here?
Flubber-dubber-pong.
Are you suggesting my house is smelly?
Flubber-dubber-dub.
Go on, be off with you. Not only trespassing, but insulting the oldest member of the community as well. What is the world coming to?
Bill asked Boo if he could think of anywhere the smell might be coming from.
Flubber-dubber-bell.
Drains could be quite smelly. Never smelt a drain that smells as bad as this, though.
Oh, well. Look what the cat dragged in. I suppose this smell has got something to do with you two.
Flubber-lub.
Ben explained that they hadn't made the smell. They were trying to find it.
Right couple of clowns you are.
The stuff from the drain that covered Ben did smell rather nasty, but it wasn't the same smell as they'd all smelled earlier.
Flubber-dubber-dower.
Ben felt a lot better and less smelly after he'd had a refreshing shower.
Flubber-dubber-dub.
Flubber-dub.
Bill thought he'd heard Ben crying, but it wasn't Ben.
Flubber-blubber-boo-boo.
Flub.
Weed! Weed-a-dubber-dub.
Weed-a.
Crying? Me? No. What have I got to cry about? It's a lovely day. The sun's shining. There is a bit of a smell about, but...
A flubbadub?
A flubbadub.
Well, yes. I heard it too. It sounds like it's coming from next door.
When Bill and Ben arrived in the garden next door, they found the smell was stronger than ever.
The flubbadubba rose.
Flubbadubba pepper.
I suppose you've come to gloat.
Flob?
Flubbadubba.
Bill and Ben explained how they'd been looking for a bad smell and how they'd heard Rose crying.
It's me! They've put a load of manure around my roots. They said it'd help me grow. But I don't want to grow if I've got to smell this bad.
Oh, flubbanure!
It's all very well for you two to laugh about it. Oh, I shall never live this down. What? Where are you going? This is so embarrassing. Roses are supposed to smell gorgeous. Not like this. No! Spades! You're not going to dig me up.
They explained that of course they weren't going to dig her up. They were going to dig the manure into the ground. That way, it will be buried together with the horrible smell.
Oh, well, get on with it. I can't stand the stench much longer. Oh, mind my roots, darling. Oh. Steady on.
Flubber lovely.
I do believe you've done it. I smell quite delicious again. Thank you both. You've done a wonderful job. There's just one thing, though.
Oh, flubble.
Would you mind leaving now? You do rather clutter up my nice, tidy garden.
Flop.
Ah, don't worry about that, Snooty Rose. The garden smells lovely again. You're a very clever pair. There's no one in the world quite like... Oh, dear.
But the flowerpot men hadn't heard. They were so tired after all their hard work that they'd fallen fast asleep and were already dreaming of another day.
Bill and Ben, the flowerpot men. Bill and Ben, the flowerpot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
One night, Bill and Ben couldn't sleep. They were too busy looking up at the moon and the stars. But then clouds filled the sky and the stars disappeared.
Okay, time for sleep.
Flubberweed.
All around the garden, Bill and Ben's friends were dropping off to sleep. In the part of the garden where Thistle lives, the man who works in the garden had put up a special light, which switched on in the dark as soon as it saw anything move.
What's that? Oh, the sun's come out.
That wasn't the sun. That was a light. A magic light.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
Oh, the sun's come out. Oh, it's gone in again.
Flubberdubberloon.
Yes, perhaps it was the moon after all. Good night.
Thistle couldn't stop laughing. She thought it's such fun to wake everybody up and send them to sleep again.
I say.
Finally, Thistle tired herself out and fell asleep.
Oh, the sun's out again. Good morning, Ben. It's a lovely sunny morning. Go and tell your friends. It would be a shame for anyone to miss such a beautiful day.
However hard they looked, Bill and Ben couldn't find any of their friends. They were worried that if Slow Coach didn't have his breakfast soon, he'd feel ill. Bill thought Ben would give Slow Coach a nasty fright, so he sent Ben to fetch some lettuce for breakfast. Ben couldn't remember what Bill had sent him to fetch.
I dare say it is a lovely sunny morning, Bill, but I didn't want to wake up yet. Oh, I was dreaming of a beautiful desert. Or was it a sand pit? Flubberdubberdashed. I dare say it is time for breakfast, but I've no lettuce in my cupboard.
Oh, flubberdub.
Oh, I flubberdub. A nut? I can't eat a nut. I haven't got the teeth for it.
Oh. Flubberdubberdub.
You know, I'd have to suck that nut, Bill. It'd take me weeks.
Ben suddenly felt very tired.
Flubberdubberdubdash! Oh, lettuce. This is more like it. Nuts indeed.
What a flubberdub.
Flubberdub.
Bill and Ben didn't understand why the sun was out in one place, but not in another.
Oh, flubberdub.
Here comes the sun, thought Ben. But Bill thought the sun would shine more brightly.
Ooh, oh, flubberdub.
Flubberdub?
It's my new shiny treasure. I thought it might be the sun.
Dear Flobbadobadon.
You're right. If the sun's shining over there, this can't be the sun. But what is it?
Robbalobbleed.
Oh, good idea. We'll ask Weed.
The man who works in the garden carries that shiny treasure at night. It's a light. But it's not a light anymore.
And it's not a shiny treasure. I'd better take it back.
That was the shortest day I can ever remember.
Flobber night.
Yes, that was the shortest night ever.
Oh, what's happening? 1 minute it's day, the next it's night. Oh, I don't know whether to sleep or wake. I'm going to hibernate.
Oh, Flobber Dumber.
No, it's not much of a summer, Bill. Look at the sun. Not very big, is it?
I thought the sun lived in the sky.
That's not the sun. It's stuck on the wall of the house.
Bill and Ben wanted a closer look at this strange new sun.
It's not the sun. It's Thistle turning that light on and off.
Flobbadob.
Yes, we must stop her. And we must pay her back.
Ben saw a strange shadow on the ground, and Bill saw that it was made by a moth in front of the light.
Yes. Let's give Thistle a fright.
What's that? A monster! Help! Oh, go away, monster, please! Has the monster really gone?
Flobbadobadite!
Well, yes, I did make it go on and off. Only a bit of fun. I won't do it again, I promise.
Flobbadobadite!
Yes, I will stay awake all night. I'll make sure no one turns the light on and off. I promise.
At last, Bill and Ben could settle down to sleep.
Oh.
But next morning, they still felt very tired. So did Weed.
At least we got some sleep last night.
Bill and Ben slept all through the day. Later on, the man who works in the garden decided he didn't like being kept awake by his light going on and off, so he took it away. So Bill and Ben slept all through the next night as well.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Friends, now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben.
afternoon, Bill and Ben had been invited to visit Slowcoach at his home. After tea, they helped Slowcoach tidy up, and then it was time to go home.
Flubba-dubba-dunk-a-dee, flubba-dub.
Oh, I am glad you came to tea, Ben, as it is, of course, my birthday. Yuck, oh, flubba-dee. I didn't tell you it was my birthday because I've only just decided that it is my birthday. It's a shame you didn't bring me a present, though. Oh, well, never mind.
You flubba-dub.
We tortoises live to such a great age, our birthday lasts for, two or three days.
Oh, flubba-dubba-dubba.
A goodbye, Bill. A goodbye, Ben.
When Bill and Ben were almost home, they had such a surprise, they forgot all about Slowcoach's birthday.
Flubba-dubba-died.
They saw the man who works in the garden. He was busy just by their own flower pots. Bill and Ben waited a long time for the man to finish his work. But at last, he went back to the house.
Here's a rub-a-dub.
Ben, I've got something to tell you. Listen, Ben, before you climb into your flower pot.
A flop?
A flop an hour.
That's what I was trying to tell you. The man planted a flower in Ben's flower pot.
But a flopper end.
I don't think the flower wants to join its friends, Bill. But it hasn't said a word since it was planted.
Would he rubber lie?
Yes, it might be shy.
Flubba-dubba-dubba-go.
It's a flower, Ben. It can't move. Time we all went to sleep. You'll both have to share Bill's flower pot. You can plan what to do in the morning. Morning, Bill. Morning, Ben. Yes. You must find a new home for that flower.
Flubba-dubba-dubba-dubba-walk.
It can't walk, Ben. Find something to carry it in.
The best place to look for things was the garden shed.
With a flubba-lub, a flubba-lub, and a flip, a flub.
Don't worry, Rob.
Flubba-flubba-dub. Flubba-dubba-dub.
Flubba-dub. Flubba-dubba-dub.
Look for a warm spot in the sunshine. That'll make the flower feel at home. Oh, that is going to be hard work.
I say, what do you think you're doing with that flower? This is a vegetable garden. It's no home for a flower. It can't live with lettuces and cabbages. It would look silly.
Rubble-ubble-day.
It's a good thing I know what I'm talking about, or this garden would soon be in a terrible mess.
What a fine morning. And it's still my birthday. Good morning, Boo. You've come to give me your best wishes, I see.
My best wishes?
And you've brought me a present for my birthday.
Have I? Oh. My word, I have been busy.
Oh, what a splendid leaf. I'll add it to my collection of pressed leaves. But first, I must sit on it.
Oh, flubber-dubber-dizzle.
Oh, no. You're not leaving that flower next to me.
Oh, Robin-Hob.
It doesn't talk, does it? Thinks it's too posh. I'm not living next to a snooty stuck-up flower like that. Take it away before I lean across and poke it with one of my prickles.
Bill and Ben found another place the flower might like to live.
Oh, hey, the flubberade.
But Bill worried that it wasn't a sunny part of the garden.
Oh, flubberdubbernick would have done.
All right, what you two got there?
Flubberdubberdubber, you've been laughing at me dropping an oak.
Well, maybe it doesn't talk because it don't understand what you're saying. That may seem strange, Ben, but perhaps this flower doesn't come from round here. Perhaps it comes from a faraway land.
A rubber-rubber-a-dee?
Oh, yeah. There are lots of faraway lands, but they're far away. That's why you don't often see them. I'll tell you what, there are flowers from faraway lands in next door's garden. Maybe this one would like to move in with them.
Oh, flubber-lubber-look-a-da-tad.
Oh, flop.
Oh, that was heavy, slow coach. That means it's top quality metal.
Well, it's very kind of you to bring it for my birthday.
Pardon?
It's my birthday today, Pry. And yesterday, and tomorrow. That's why all my friends are bringing me presents.
Oh, I see. Well, happy birthday.
Thank you. Oh, and thank you for the present.
That is nothing but an ordinary, rather common pansy.
What?
A flower?
It certainly can't stay here. This garden has nothing but the smartest flowers, orchids, the better class of lupin, and, of course, prize roses, such as myself.
Flubbala.
I'm sorry, but my buds must be set only the very best examples.
Bill and Ben took the pansy back to their own garden. It seemed to get heavier and heavier.
What's all that noise? It's still my birthday, you know. Oh, you remembered. You brought me a present. Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Ben. This flower is my best birthday present. It can live with me forever and ever.
Everyone was happy. Slowcoach had a present. The flower had a home. And once again, Ben his own flower pot.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men.
It was a beautiful morning in the garden. The sunshine had woken Bill and Ben, and they were getting up to greet a new day.
Flubber-wee-hid-ho.
Good morning, Bill. Good morning, Ben.
Flubber-weed.
And what are you two going to do today?
Flubber-looking-fool, and a plunk-a-flub, and a flub-ear-flub, eat-a-flubber-gobble-a-flub.
Flubber-dub. Bill and Ben couldn't think of anything they wanted to do. But Weed had an idea.
Oh, why don't we have a treasure hunt?
Flubber-dub-a-dub-a-dub-a-dub.
What's a treasure hunt? It's simple. Everyone goes and searches for something really interesting. And whoever finds the most interesting thing in the garden wins a prize. Why don't you go and get some of the others to play as well?
Oh, Flub.
Flub.
Slubber-dub.
Slubber-dub.
What's happening? Dear, is this an emergency? Has the sky fallen in? An earthquake? Oh, it's you two. Oh, I should have known. What is it this time?
Flubber-dubber-dissident.
We're not caught in it, and the flubber-dubber-rise. A treasure hunt? A prize? What do I want with a treasure hunt? Now clear off and leave me in peace.
Soon, Bill and Ben had found plenty of other contestants for the treasure hunt. There were Scamper the Squirrel, Boo the Hedgehog, Pry the Magpie...
Can I play too?
...and Whoops the Worm.
I always thought I'd make a good treasure hunter. Take after my great Uncle Willoughby, the exploring worm I do. He discovered Africa, you know. Well, that's what he told me, and I have no reason not to believe him.
Except he was a worm.
Oh.
Of course you can play Whoops. Now, are you all ready?
Flubby!
Then on your marks, get set, go!
The flower pot men thought they might find something interesting in the garden next door.
Oh,
I say, you...
Flub?
Yes, you. Are you two grubby little flower pot things? What are you up to?
Flubber-lubber-chedron.
Flubber-lub.
Well, let me tell you. I am probably the most important and interesting thing in this garden.
Oh.
Or any other garden, for that matter.
Oh,
ouch! Oh! Unhand me, you ruffians! Look what you've done to me! This is an outrage! Be off with you at once!
Flubby!
Are they gone?
Ages ago!
Yes, I'm sure I've got just the very thing somewhere here. I can't lose. I wish people wouldn't creep up on me like that. What now?
Oh, bother. Only a silly old pebble. Still, I'm bound to win. And I'm going to find something. Something shiny and sensational and simply splendid.
Bill and Ben searched and searched and searched, but they didn't find anything that looked like treasure. Then Bill remembered the potting shed.
Flubber-dub!
They were bound to find something really interesting in there. as usual, the potting shed was full of interesting stuff.
Flubberdum?
Flub?
Bill thought he'd heard something. The something, whatever it was ticking very quietly.
Flubberdog!
Bill and Ben had never seen a clock before. But whatever it was, Bill and Ben decided that they were bound to win the prize for the most interesting thing.
Oh, Flob!
Up there, I was looking for treasure and I found it! It's horrible! Horrible! Save me!
I've been searching and I still haven't found it. Hey, God! I think I have. Now, that's what I call treasure. I'll wait till the others see this. I'll win the prize hands down.
Bill and Ben had found the thing that had so scared Whoops, but they weren't at all sure what it was.
Careful, it might bite you. Look at its huge mouth. It'll have you for breakfast if you're not careful. Oh, it looks really fierce to me. Don't get too close, watch it. Oh, it's got a nasty look to it.
Oi, hey, what's all this noise? I blame you all too, you and your blooming treasure.
Look out, Slowcoach. It'll have your leg off given half a chance.
Oh, what will?
That.
Lettuce? It's eating lettuce. My lettuce. How dare you? That lettuce is mine, you. You. Well, what have you got to say for yourself? Go on, speak up. And what do you find so amusing, Pry?
Slowcoach, that's a sandwich.
I don't care what it is, it's eating my lettuce.
Hey, everyone, look what I got. My treasure's going to beat yours. It's brilliant, it is, look. Oh, flubber-dubber-dead.
Bill and Ben ran back to the potting shed for their treasure.
There. What do you make of that?
It's, very nice, Boo.
Yes, it... Oh, it's broken. Bother.
Never mind, Boo, but I think I've won. Look at this. Oh, it's very nice, Pry, but not as exciting as this. What's that?
Well, whatever it is, I think it wins first prize in the treasure hunt.
Whoopsie's treasure wins. It's delicious.
And as Slowcoach tucked into the lettuce in the sandwich, everyone agreed that the treasure hunt had been a great success.
Oh, yeah.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot. Now they'll be sleeping in that